Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math School Learn to Succeed. In this channel, I'll be teaching you Karnataka Board Class 10th SLC NCERT Math. In today's video, let us solve the question number 4, 5 and 6 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions. In my previous videos, I have solved the questions from 1 to 3 from the same exercise. If you have not watched that video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So before we begin the video, please like and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos. In today's video, let us solve the question number 4 from exercise 1.3. It says, how many terms of the AP 9,17,25 must be taken to give a sum of 636? So here they're asking us how many terms means we have to find out the n value for the sum 636. So here in the question they have given AP is 9,17,25 and so on with the sum Sn is equal to 636 and we have to find out the n value here. So let us write down the formula for the sum. Sn is equal to n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So from the given AP we can find out the a value of that is the first term that is equal to 9 and d is equal to a2 minus a1 that is the second term minus the first term which is 17 minus 9 and d value is equal to 17 minus 9 is 8. So let us substitute all this value and find out the n value. So what is Sn? It is 636 is equal to n divided by 2 into 2 into a is 9 plus n minus 1 into d is 8. So 636 is equal to n divided by 2, 9 2s are 18 plus if you open the brackets we get 8 into n is 8n minus 8. Okay, what is 18 minus 8? N by 2 into 18 minus 8 is 10 plus 8n. So let us open this bracket. N by 2 into 10 plus n by 2 into 8n. Okay, so this is 636. So if we cancel 2 1 times to 5 times, then 2 1 times to 4 times. Therefore we get 636 is equal to 5n plus 4n square. So this is a quadratic equation. If we send 636 to the right hand side, we will get 4n square plus 5n minus 636 is equal to 0. So let us solve this equation by splitting the middle term 5n. So for the quadratic equation, 4n square plus 5n minus 636 is equal to 0. Let us write the a value. A value here it is 4, that is the coefficient of n square. Then b value is the coefficient of n, that is 5. And c is the coefficient without n, that is 636. Here we are not taking any signs, we are just taking the numbers. So now a into c we have to find out, that is 4 into 636, that is equal to 6 4s are 24, 4 3s are 12 plus 2 it is 14, carry 1, and 6 4s are 24 plus 1 it will be 25. So AC value is 2544. So the product of the coefficient should be 2544. Since here minus sign is there, we are taking the difference. If plus was there, you would take the sum. So the difference should be the B term, that is nothing but 5. So let us factorize 2544 and find the coefficient. So 2544, if we factorize this term, so 2 1 times, 2 2s are 4, carry 1. So 2 7s are, 2 2s are again. So 2 6s are 12, 2 3s are 6, carry 1. Again 2 6s are 12. Okay, so again if you take 2 table, 2 3s are 6, 2 1s are 2, 2 8s are 16. So again if 2 table, if you take 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10, 2 9s are 18. Now this is not divisible by 2, we'll take the number 3. So 3 5s are 15, 3 3s are 9. So 53 1 times. So because this is a prime number which is divisible by itself. So now if we multiply 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 into 3 is 48. Now 48 into 53 is nothing but 2544. So 48 into 53, we got the result as 2544. That is the product. Now 53 minus 48 will be equal to 5. That is the difference. Okay, so instead of 5, here we will write 53 minus 48. That is 53 minus 48 minus 636 is equal to 0. Or this will be 4n square plus 53n minus 48n minus 636 is equal to 0. Or take n common, we are left with 4n plus 53. And here if we take minus 12, we will be left with 4n, because 12 into 4, it is 48. 4n minus into minus will be plus 53 equal to 0. Take again 4n plus 53 as common, we will be left with n minus 12 is equal to 0, or 4n plus 53 is equal to 0, or n minus 12 is equal to 0, or we can write it as n is equal to minus 53 divided by 4, or n is equal to 12. So since we can't take the negative terms, the n value can never be negative, should be always a positive counting number. Therefore, we'll take n value is equal to 12. So therefore, we got the terms, the number of terms for the sum s is equal to 636 is n is equal to 12. Now let us solve the question number 5 from exercise 1.3, which says the first term of an AP is 5, the last term is 45, and the sum is 400. Find the number of terms and the common difference. So let us write down what is given first. The first term of AP is 5. The last term is also known as the nth term. So we can write L, or the nth term is equal to 45, and the sum is, sum for n terms, it is 400. Find the number of terms and the common difference. So we have to find out the number of terms and common difference. First of all, let us write down, let A be the first term and D be the common difference of the AP. Since the AP's values are not given, we are assuming A to be the first term and D to be the common difference. So let us use the formula SN is equal to N by 2. Since here the last term is given, we will take formula as A plus L. So substitute the values and find out the N value. So SN is 400 is equal to N divided by 2 into A is 5 plus the last term is 45. Or we can write it as 400 is equal to N divided by 2 into 5 plus 45 is 50. So 2 1 times, 2 2's are 4, 5. So this will be N is equal to 400 divided by 25. So 5 5's are 5, 8's are 40, 5 1's are 5, 1's are 5, 5 6's are 30. Okay, therefore we got N value is equal to 16. Okay. Now again we have to find out the D value. This can be found out by using the nth term formula, since the nth term is given here. So the nth term formula AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So we know the A value, we know the nth term, and we also know the N value. So we have to just find out the D value by substituting all the values. So the nth term is given by 45 is equal to, the first term is 5 plus N is 16 minus 1 into D. So this is 45 is equal to 5 plus 16 minus 1 is 15D. Or if we send this 5 to the left hand side, we get 45 minus 5 is equal to 15D. 45 minus 5 is 40 is equal to 15D, or D is equal to 40 divided by 15. So 5 3s are 5, 8s are 40. So D is equal to 8 divided by 3. This is the common difference, and here N is the number of terms. So this is how we solve this problem. Now let us solve the question number 6 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, arithmetic progressions. So the question says the first and the last term of an AP are 17 and 350 respectively. If the common difference is 9, how many terms are there and what is their sum? So first of all, let us write down the first term, which is given by A. The first term of the AP is 17, and the last term L, or it is also nth term AN, it is 350. The common difference is given, that is d is equal to 9. And how many terms are there? How many terms means we have to find out the n value. We have to find the n value and its sum. So first of all, let us write down, let a be the first term, a be the first term, and d be the common difference of the AP. Now, since the nth term is given, let us find out the n value by using the nth term formula first. So an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So we know here the nth term value, we know the first term a and d value. We have to find out the n value by substituting those values. So an is 350 is equal to, the first term is 17, plus n minus 1 into d is 9. So 350 is equal to 17 plus 9n minus n. What is 350 is equal to? 17 minus 9 is 8 plus 9n, or send this 8 to the left hand side, we get 350 minus 8 is equal to 9n. So this will be 342 is equal to 9n, or n is equal to 342 divided by 9. So if we simplify with the number 3, so 3 3s are 3, 1s are 3, 1s are 3, 4s are 12, or again, yeah, 3 1 times 3, 3s are 9, so 24 is left, 3 8s are 24. Therefore, we got n is equal to 38. Now, let us find out the sum Sn. We will use the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l, since the last term is given. Okay, so let us substitute the values of n, a, n, n, and find out the sum value. Therefore, Sn is equal to, what is n? 38 divided by 2 into a is 17 plus l is 350. So this will be 38 divided by 2 into, what is 350 plus 17? This will be 76. So this will be 367 into 367, or 2 1 times 2 1 times 2 9s are 18. So let us multiply 367 into 19. So 7 9s are 63. 6 9s are 54 plus 6, it will be 60. Again, 9 3s are 27. So 27 plus 6 is 33 into 1 7s are 7, 1 6 are 6, and 1 3s are 3. So 3 7, 6 plus 3 is 9, and 3 plus 3 is 6. Therefore, the sum of the n terms Sn is equal to 6973. So this is the result. Therefore, we can write down number of terms of AP is equal to 38 and 6973. So this is how we solve this problem. If you have any doubts, please comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, I'll be solving the question number 7 from exercise 1.3. So till then, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.